We all have settled on a flawed decision, or 100 of them, through the span of our lives. Fortunately, a large portion of us are outfitted with the capacity to gain from our slip-ups and to abstain from making similar goofs later on. One may think this is circumstances and logical results. You get in a tough situation for settling on a terrible decision, so you don't make it once more. Be that as it may, as we've seen with Hollywood, it is hard to break liberated from this cycle. A large portion of this boils down to choice. Green or purple? You choose. Loathe down-home music? Try not to hear it out. Need to trust in unwarranted fear-inspired notions? Get out your tinfoil cap. Presently, imagine a scenario in which we revealed to you that the decisions you make, the great, awful, monstrous, and dumb, regardless of how minuscule, aren't really decisions by any stretch of the imagination. Rather, they're simply the consequence of a progression of compound motivations, natural variables, or both. Sounds insane, isn't that so? For reasons unknown, not really. A gigantic discussion is blending on the benefits of alleged unrestrained choice. To many noted scientists, the entire idea has been consigned to the domain of religion as the thought doesn't relate to our physical world. They accept that through and through freedom is a deception. At the point when you are confronted with a decision between three entryways, you think you have a decision when, actually, your organic chemistry decides for you. Staying alert that you have numerous ways to browse doesn't imply that you intentionally get the opportunity to settle on the decision. So, don't go ransacking a lemonade stand feeling that the courts will purchase the through and through freedom as a figment strategy. That is, except if you are set up to have said lemons crushed into your eyeballs. Along these lines, in Shattering, reality itself isn't significantly more practical than unscripted TV shows are. Our world is similarly as abstract, perhaps more in this way, as close to home preferences for music, food, and amusement are. That won't change soon in light of the fact that every individual is outfitted with a one-of-a-kind arrangement of factors, with vision and hearing, particularly. On the off chance that that doesn't make you question everything, we don't have the foggiest idea what could.